Today we are going to study about data visualization, data analysis, and thesis writing, unit number 7. This unit is very much important. It will give you an insight about data visualization and analysis. And likewise, we will also discuss about the thesis writing. Let's look into the topics that will be covered in this unit. There are major 5 topics. In this unit, we'll study about descriptive stats or descriptive statistics, inferential statistics, statistical analysis, and its 3 major types: qualitative analysis, quantitative analysis, and mixed method analysis. We'll study about these 3 types of data analysis. And likewise, how do we write findings and conclusion and recommendations in a thesis? And likewise, organization, formatting, and references of thesis. And it will be the last topic, and it will be the end of your course as well. Now let's start. First, descriptive statistics. In this topic, we have 2 terms: descriptive and statistics. Let's first study about these 2 terms. The word statistics basically is a branch of applied mathematics. Remember, statistics is a branch of applied mathematics that simply deals with collection and analysis of data. Again, I'm going to repeat. Statistics is the branch of applied mathematics. In mathematics, it has many branches: fundamental mathematics, pure mathematics, functional mathematics, likewise applied mathematics. And applied mathematics, we have again many branches. One of them is statistics. In statistics, we study about collection and analysis of data. Simple, very simple definition. Let's look into, for further details, let's look into the definition of a statistics again. What is statistics? Again, statistics is a broad subject, and it is applied in a vast number of fields. Wherever we'll talk about analysis of data, either it is in education, it is either medical sciences, social sciences, and astrophysics and chemistry, in approximately in all fields of life, statistics is being applied. In economics, in business, wherever data is there, there will be statistics. And statistics has 2 major roles: collection and analysis of data. This is a very simple definition that I have shared with you. The definition can be lengthy as well, but at this stage, we'll only talk about collection and analysis of data. And as far as statistics is concerned, it is a field of study, complete field of study. And it is a so vast and so in-depth field of study that people, they do MPhil, MS, and PhD in this field. It is not a simple topic, it is a complete domain. It is a very deep history as well. Now, we'll proceed further. As I have told, you have seen that statistics is a basically analysis of data. And what is descriptive statistics? Again, there are 2 words: descriptive and statistics. Basically, in a statistics, we have 2 types of statistics: descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. Descriptive statistics, as the name suggests, it describes, it explains what data. It explains data, it describes data. How there are different descriptive statistics indicators or different way functions that we perform that can be visualization of data through charts and graph, and that can be, and I'm talking about descriptive stats, and that can be simple analysis of data. Now we'll proceed further. Now we'll look into descriptive stats again. In descriptive stats, as I've told you, that it describes the data, it try to visualize, try to understand the data about the sample. And it gives answer to the many questions as well. The concept of population and sample had already been discussed. Basically, I have told you in the previous class that population is the collection of all individuals and items which are under consideration. And whereas sample is the subset of population, or sample is the part of population from which the information is collected. For example, there are millions of students who are studying in schools. If you want to know the level of satisfaction or parental satisfaction about the education in that is being provided in a school, we can, in place of studying or in place of collecting data from millions of families, it will be more appropriate to ask 1,000 families or 2,000 families that what is their opinion, or are they satisfied from the education that is being provided in schools. The part of the population from whom you will ask this question, that part will be called your sample. And logic of taking sample, I had already discussed in the previous discussion, that it is time saving, it gives more accuracy. Population, again, it is a basically subset of the population. Sample is a subset of population. And population are the individuals with same traits and characteristics which are under study. Now, descriptive statistics. Descriptive statistics, basically, again, very simple concept, just to make the things clear and to make the things understandable. Descriptive statistics consist of methods for organizing and summarizing information. This is the crux of the definition. And if you remember these three words, organizing, summarizing information, and four words, organizing and summarizing information, basically this is the main purpose of descriptive statistics. Through descriptive statistics, we organize information, we summarize information. And what is inferential statistics? Inferential statistics, basically, it helps us to generalize information on the whole population. Descriptive statistics is related to sample only. We discuss the sample, the information of regarding about the sample. We organize the information that is collected from the sample. In descriptive statistics, again, I'm going to repeat, we collect, we summarize the information related to the sample only. Whereas in inferential statistics, the information obtained from a sample is generalized on the population. Because if suppose the example that I have given you, that you have collected information from 2000 families, that what is, are they satisfied about the education that is being provided in schools? This is your simple question. You are want to know the satisfaction of the parents about the education being provided in schools. and your sample size is 2000 families. Now, if 2000 families are satisfied, it means whole population will also be satisfied. You can generalize, you can conclude and that all parents would be satisfied from the quality of education that is being provided in schools. If these 2000 families that you have had collected as a sample, if 2000 families, majority of them, if our sample, the people included in our sample, if they are not satisfied, they are showing dissatisfaction from the education, then we can say that our population will also be dissatisfied. Our population has no satisfaction from the education being provided in schools. And if the people included in sample, they say they are agreed and they are satisfied, it means our population will, other people will also be satisfied. That in inferential statistics, basically we generalize the findings, the result on the whole population. Again, the information derived from the sample is generalized on the whole population when we are talking about inferential stats. In inferential stats, here you can say that inferential stats basically helps us, it allows us to make predictions, to make inferences. Because inferential statistics, the word basically based on inferences. We can generalize the information collected through the sample on the whole population. This is the basic understanding about inferential stats and descriptive stats. This is the basic difference between two branches of statistics. I am going to again repeat whatever I've taught you. Statistics is a branch of applied mathematics that deals with collection and analysis of data. There are two types of statistics, descriptive and inferential stats. Descriptive stats, it deals with the simple description of the population of the sample. We simply summarize information, we gather information through descriptive statistics, we organize the data, we summarize the data when we are talking about descriptive statistics. And inferential statistics deal with the inferences, deals with the generalization of the information on the whole population. Let's proceed further. What is included in descriptive statistics? Until yet we had studied about that what is inferential stats and what is descriptive stats. Now let's proceed further that what is inside descriptive and what is inside inferential stats. In descriptive stats, okay, this is a basically a flowchart diagram or conceptual diagram of our application of statistics and where does the statistics is applied. In our research starts from the formulation of research problem. At first stage, we start our research from our research problem. Then at second stage, we define our population and sample, that who will be our population and what sample size we will draw from that population. Then we collect data from the sample, not from the population. So remember, data is always collected from the sample. As I've told you earlier, that there are millions of students, they go to school daily. There are many, many families, thousands of families who are sending their children to the schools. but in sample you have included only 2000 families. Now you will collect data only from these 2000 families which are part of your sample. Then collection of data is basically from the sample, not from the population. We later on generalize the information on the whole population. Now, the next stage, it is descriptive data analysis. At first stage, we organize and we summarize our data. That is also called summary statistics. We later on learn about that. Then at the next stage, we use appropriate statistical method in order to solve the problem, in order to generalize the sample information on the whole population. This is a procedure of our research. This is the application basically. This is a systematic way. And then the last stage, it is a report writing or thesis writing. You have seen that statistics is very much important in research. Without statistics, without data analysis, you cannot conduct a good research. Now, the words, there are some terminologies that are very much important to understand. Here, the first terminology is variable. Variable, as the name suggests, that any characteristics that varies from one person to other person, that is called variable. Again, any characteristics that varies from person to person, that is basically a variable. Or thing to another is called a variable. Or again, a characteristic that varies from one person or one thing to another thing to another person. Complete definition. Suppose now there are approximately 49 students are present in the class. If I'll ask your age, all the students don't have same age. There will be variation in the age. This characteristic will vary from person to person, and age is a variable. Likewise, your weight. All students don't have same weight. There is a variation in the weight. That is again a variable. Likewise, your previous qualification. All students sitting in the classroom, they don't have same education. They don't have same education or same type of education at least. Possibly number of your education are same. Majority of the students, they have 16 years of education, but there are students who have 18 years of education or more than that. So type of education, it is again a variable. Year of education, it is again a variable. Your age, your weight, this is again a variable. Likewise, if I'll ask you the number of years of teaching experience that you have, some of the students, they might have taught in some schools, somewhere else, in some tuition centers. They would have some, might have some teaching experience as well. And some of the students, they don't have at all. So again, teaching experience is a variable. Likewise, income, family income. Family income again, all students, they don't have same level of family income. There will be some variation. Again, this is a variable. Again, another example, family members, family size. Some students, they have smaller family. Some of the students, they have larger families. These are all variables. The variables that I have discussed now, these variables can take two forms, quantitative or qualitative. If your answer is in number, if a value is numerical, then it is a quantitative variable. If it is a categorical or a text or a category, then it is a qualitative variable. Suppose I ask you about your type of education. The type of education is purely a qualitative variable. It is not a quantitative variable. But if I'm asking you about number of family members in your family, likewise your family income, your weight, your age, these all variables are purely quantitative variables because the answer will be in numbers. So from this we learned that variable is a basically characteristics that has a that vary from person to person, that can take many forms. And we had studied, we knew that there are two types of variable, quantitative and qualitative. Basically, in statistics, in research, we deal with variables. And then as far as variables are concerned, because variables makes the data. Variables provides the data. And as far as data is concerned, we had learned in the previous lecture that there are four types of data: nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio data. These are the four types of data that we have already studied about that. Now we come to the basically application of descriptive statistics. Application of descriptive stats, first we learn about the basic concepts. First and the foremost concept that is very much simple, this is calculating the mean of mean or average. Majority of the students, they are well versed about how to calculate the mean. We'll learn after a few minutes, but at the same time, you know that we will work on the visualization of data as well. And we will work on that as well. Now, I will go to simply Excel. I will open Excel sheet for you and I will let you know, because there are many softwares that can be used to analyze data. The simplest, the most commonly used and most commonly available software, it is Excel, but it's not commonly used. It is easily available. Now I would like to share with you the Excel sheet so that you can visualize the analysis of data. It is not part of our today's lecture, but despite of that, I'm giving you an explanation. Suppose I have students A, B, C, D, E, and F. Suppose I have these students. These are my students. And these are scores. They obtained in a particular subject. Suppose there was a class test and they got there was total score, the out of 10, they got, suppose student A, he got 9, and then another student B, he got 5, then there was another student, she got 9, then another student, she got 9, and then another, he got 8, and then another student, he got 4. These are simple scores. And if we want to calculate average or mean, that's very, it's not so complicated. Simply, you will go to function, this option, if you can visualize. Let me annotate at the same time so that you can visualize the things properly. This is the option. This is function option. You will opt for that and you will put your cursor first with the place where you want to get the output function. Now you will, what you want to calculate, what you want to find. I want to find average. Average already, it is mentioned here. I have opted for average or mean, okay. Then it is asking about the average number from C to C. It is, sorry. Now it's just to press okay. our average is 7.333. Now it's up to me that if I'm going to format the cell accordingly, so that I could see only the data, not so lengthy, but I will format the cells so that I could see only three digit number. I said that only two digit after the decimal. Now 7.33. This is the answer. Now, first step, I have calculated mean. It was basically calculation of mean through Excel, and majority of the students, they have knowledge about that. Possibly it would be a repetition for them. It is a mean or average. How does Excel actually calculate? The calculation of mean is very simple. I will share with you a formula as well. First of all, Excel summed up all the values. Likewise, if I'm going to sum up of all values, I will sum up sum. It is a sum of value 44. How many values are there? There are these values, six values are. These are six values. If I will divide, every calculation starts from equal sign. If I'll divide 44 with 6, I will get the same answer, 7.33. Basically, average or mean, its formula, sum of all values divided by number of values. Look into this formula. What did I do? I divided the sum 44 minus divided by 6 values. That was the basically formula to calculate mean of anything. And mean is basically a part of descriptive stats, and it helps us to understand and to summarize the information. Now, if I want to calculate mode, basically, remember, mode is the most repeating value. Most repeating value is called the mode. Mode is the most repeating value. Now, which value is the most repeated value in this text? If you look into that, yes, it's 9. 9 is the number that is most repeated number, because look at that, 9 is here, 9 is there, 9 is here. So mode is the most repeating value. So its mode is 9. This mode can be calculated through statistics, through Excel as well. Excel can calculate mode for us. If I want to calculate mode through Excel, this is a data that is based on only 6 observations. If a data is composed of 1,000 or 2,000 observations, it is very difficult. It will take a lot of time to calculate mode manually. But Excel can calculate, find mode very quickly. Now, if I want to calculate mode through Excel, simple. I'm going to find mode. I will go to function and I will write here mode. It will search mode for go. It will go and it will find mode for me. This is the first one. Look at here, mode. I will click on it. But yes, I will have to ask the select the data. Look at that. It is already giving here the answer 9. If I'll hit the OK button, 9. This is the mode that is calculated by Excel itself. In today's lecture, we have learned about two concepts, yet mean and mode through Excel. Now, visualization of data. If I want to visualize data, visualize means to see the data through graphs, bar, and charts. I can do that as well. Now, how I can do that? It's very again simple. In order to draw a graph, I will have to select the data first. I have selected my variables. Score is a variable, and my students, these are basically my respondents. And it is the tool of data collection that I used. It is test. Test as a tool of data collection. Now I will go to insert. Now I'll go to column. Now I'll go to bar. Simple. Okay. Simply I look at that. I got the bar graphs of my all students. Student A. Now if I want to label, there are no labels, but I can read this bar graphs very easily. How I can read that? Look at that. That student A, here student A, he got 9 score. And here, look at, he got 9 because his graph, his bar is touching the level 9. Likewise, the student B, 5 score, student B here, and it is again equivalent to 5. Very simple. Now we can label these bars as well. So in order to label these bars, we can go and we can ask the formatting of the chart, and we can change and format chart area. Note, we are not formatting chart area at this moment. We're just closing it. We're just labeling. I went to that. I add data labels. What did I do? I right click on a bar graph, and then I click on format, or I add data labels. Likewise, I can add trend line. Trend line means I will see the change. It is asking about the color and line and other things. I say the automatic. Look at that. That where the performance is going. But in this situation, the trend line was not necessary. I am doing Control Z. This is the end of today's lesson. We have learned about statistics, types of statistics, data, variable, types of variables, descriptive stats, and in descriptive stats, we have studied about two functions, mean and mode. The third function is median. Median is the basically central value. We will study about the central value in next class. Here, if any query, any question is there, you may ask me. Now it's time is for you. There are a few minutes remaining to end the class.
Sir, मुझे आपसे ये पूछना है कि जो descriptive statistic है और inferential है, क्या इसका जो quantitative और qualitative data है, उससे कोई link है?
हाँ, बहुत अच्छा सवाल किया आपने, शाबाश. असल में क्या है कि जो descriptive stats है और जो हमारी quantitative research studies होती हैं, उसमें तो हम दोनों इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैट्स को भी इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं और इन्फ्रेंशियल को इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. और जो हमारी क्वालिटेटिव स्टडी है, उसमें हम इसमें भी इस्तेमाल हो सकते हैं, लेकिन थोड़ा सा लिमिटेशंस आती हैं. उसमें हमारे पास इतनी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी नहीं होती. वो डिपेंड करता है हमारे डेटा पे. हम बस इन्फ्रेंशियल स्टैट्स के स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल्स और टेस्ट लगा सकते हैं और ज़्यादातर नहीं लगते. और अगर हमारी कोई डेटा इस तरह का है जिसमें कि हमारे पास जैसे कि लिंग्विस्टिक में जो हमारे पास या हम प्योरली अगर लिटरेचर में चले जाएं, वहां पर जो रिसर्च स्टडीज होती हैं, वहां पर हम इन्फ्रेंशियल स्टैट्स बिल्कुल इस्तेमाल नहीं कर सकते. हम मैक्सिमम जो जाएंगे वो डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैट्स में जाएंगे. और डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैट्स में भी जो हम चीज इस्तेमाल करेंगे वो मोड इस्तेमाल होता है. ज्यादातर मोड ही इस्तेमाल होता है या फ्रीक्वेंसी इस्तेमाल होती है. फ्रीक्वेंसी माना कितनी बार कोई चीज आ रही है. जैसे फर्ज करें 9 जो है 3 बार आया, 8 वन टाइम आया, 4 वन टाइम आया, 5 वन टाइम आया. तो इसी तरह हम जब किसी का इंटरव्यू लेते हैं तो इंटरव्यू में हमारे पास जो रेस्पोंडेंट्स होते हैं, जैसे 10 रेस्पोंडेंट थे, 9 रेस्पोंडेंट ने कहा हाँ और 1 रेस्पोंडेंट ने कहा ना, तो हम कहेंगे कि जो फ्रीक्वेंसी थी रेस्पोंडेंट्स की वो 9 था, उसका मोड 9 था, 9 था मतलब. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन प्लीज.
टिप जो है वो मतलब कि इंटरव्यू वगैरह इस टाइप के टूल्स के लिए यूज होता है?
वहां भी इस्तेमाल होता है, प्योर क्वांटिटेटिव में भी इस्तेमाल होता है, जब हम परसेंटेज, एवरेज, मोड और स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इन चीजों को लेते हैं, तो ये सारे का सारा बेसिकली डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैट्स है। ये हम प्योर क्वांटिटेटिव रिसर्च में भी इस्तेमाल करते हैं और क्वालिटेटिव में भी इस्तेमाल करते हैं। बेसिकली जो इन्फॉर्मेशन स्टैट्स,
मीन्स द डेटा इन नंबर्स जो है वो डिस्क्रिप्टिव है?
नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है।